This is dice stacking, and it is extremely cool. Dice stacking basically consists in scooping dice off a flat surface with a cup and using centripetal force to stack the dice in a column. I literally couldn't wait to try it, so I bought the dice and I grabbed the first plastic cup I could find. And even if I had no idea how to do it, I started practicing.
Good start.
And I have to admit, I thought it was easier, but things didn't go as planned. Because after 50 minutes, the only thing I managed to do was throwing dice all over my room. I also tried with different types of cups. I mean, anything I could find similar to a cup. And it got a bit better, but not enough. So I decided to change approach.
Let's start from the basics. I need to pick up the first dice.
Sometimes I've been lucky managing to get the dice into the cup, but most of the times
this happened.
Then, after watching a few videos, I realized that by keeping the cup almost parallel to the table and hitting the dice really fast, the dice should go inside the cup consistently. So I kept trying. And then something clicked.
Ooh! I got something. I think the secret is not to roll the glass on the table, but like touching the table where the dice is. This way is much better. See?
The way you can keep the dice inside the cup is immediately turning the cup to the other side, so that the dice will roll to the back without flying away. And I've been lucky, because I kinda did that intuitively. So I was extremely excited to move to the next step, picking up another dice while keeping the first one inside the cup.
And here's where our freehand physics comes into play.
Because the only way to keep the dice at the bottom of the cup is to perform a continuous motion like this one. With this movement, we take advantage of something called centripetal force,
which can be easily explained. By a barrel flip. Let's go!
When you spin a barrel without the cup or even a glass full of water, the rotation creates a force that makes the water follow the curved path of the barrel, so that the water doesn't fall at least as long as the cup spins.
Just for you.
So after picking up the first dice, we basically have to keep turning the cup left and right to maintain the dice at the bottom.
I started trying, and surprisingly, I was getting decent results right away.
Nice. The big problem here is stacking the dice on top of each other. I kept trying over and over, but despite the practice, I really couldn't get it.
Oh my God. I've got a new cup and casino dice. Hopefully this will help me out. Nope.
And even if a better equipment didn't really solve my problems, I decided to do the only thing you can do in these cases. Keep trying.
And while I was contemplating the life choices that brought me to that moment, I watched a few tutorials and I realized what I was doing wrong.
I tried to keep the cup almost parallel to the table and be more gentle.
Instead of smashing the cup on the table from the top with evil intention, I tried making the cup slide really fast to the left.
And after a bunch of struggling and frustration, this happened.
Yes! Look at this! It's all about the last motion. If you do it this way, the dice will stay on the side of the cup and you'll be able to stack them. That's great!
This adjustment really changed everything. And from here, stacking three dice has been a bit harder than I thought, but in the end, I got it.
Let's go!
Then I got four.
Oh my God! There's people staring at me. Let's go. Look at this. This is progress.
Now, stacking five dice is the first of two goals of the video.
And after 20 minutes, my brain started to really understand what I was trying to do.
And I managed to pick up five dice, keeping them inside the cup for a few seconds, and with a bit of external help, successfully stacking them on the table.
Let's go.
Don't get me wrong, it took me a while to get fluid and comfortable with the movement, but I kept trying, especially because stacking five dice is only half of the final challenge. Really, the more fluid and gentle your movement is, the easier it gets to land the trick. I also tried to pick up five dice extremely fast, and it's hard, but doable, especially by keeping the cup really close to the table.
I am super fast. I'm not sure why I am in the grass, but I wanna try to do this.
And when I got able to stack five dice consistently, I decided to move to the final step.
Because you know what's better than stacking five dice on a table? Stacking five dice on top of five dice. I saw a bunch of people trying it and I couldn't resist. But I quickly regret my decision when I realized how hard it actually is.
At first, I was trying the usual movement from side to side, moving the new dice on top of the five ones on the table as fast as I could. And after practicing for a good 10 minutes, the only thing I managed to do was destruction.
And then, you already know what happened. Tutorials. Hundreds of tutorials.
So after looking for answers all over the internet, I was ready to start trying again.
With practice and time, you can do anything in lime.
And this time I tried a different approach. Instead of stacking the dice gently, I tried to push down really hard on top of the five dice on the table. I wasn't really sure what I was doing, and in the beginning, literally nothing changed. So I really didn't know what else I could try. But then I realized that the guy I saw in the video was keeping four dice on the table and six inside the cup, instead of five and five. And so I tried that too.
And literally, as soon as I did that, this happened. Let me try again. Let's go!
Keeping 6 dice inside the cup reduces their movement right before stacking them. And this really changed everything. I also tried a different technique to hold the cup. And suddenly the trick started to get way easier than before. And after about 2 hours in total of practice, I've been able to stack 6 dice on top of 4 others consistently. And I was insanely happy about it.
I'm following back one random person that follows me on Instagram. Subscribe and click the bell for more skills and content like this. I'll see you next week with a new skill.